Hello everyone, my name is Nisal and today I will present So Predictable, Continuous 3D Hand Gesture Prediction in Virtual Reality. This work was done together with Deepana, Ishtaweera, Martin Weigel and Anusha Withana, and we are from University of Sydney, Australia, Honda Research Institute, Europe and University of Moratuwa, Sri Lanka. In this work, we present a kinematics-based regression model for ballistic hand movements in VR, which outperforms classical kinematics models. Our model is both user and activity independent, which makes it usable without additional training. And to validate our model, we also conducted the follow-up study with new users and activities. Have you experienced lagging in applications? It is also a concern in VR, which is our primary motivation for this project. For highly immersive VR experiences, latency remains a major challenge. When there is a significant delay in feedback, users can notice asynchrony, which leads to negative VR experiences. Our work builds upon previous work, which has explored various predictive models for reducing latency in VR. Most predictive models are often limited to endpoint prediction. However, not only the end of the movement, but predicting a continuous movement is important. For example, consider a VR user playing boxing with a virtual character. The collision between the two boxers is not at the end point, but along the trajectory of the movement. By anticipating the trajectory, these events can be predicted, and it enables novel applications such as pre-rendering graphics and preemptive haptics. Now, I will move on to how we built our model. Our goal was to develop a formula to estimate hand location for a future time t while minimizing the error between the predicted and the actual location. To build our model, we collected data from 20 participants utilizing the OptiTrack motion capture system. We collected data for two tasks, a structured task, which included reaching and pointing movements, and a gaming task, which included three third-party games, which imitated movements in swordplay, boxing, and table tennis. We first tested our data with classical kinematics models, but as seen in this graph, with the classical models, prediction accuracy decreased rapidly after time exceeded 160 milliseconds. So, our next step was to use 15% of the data as training data, and we applied regression to build personalized models. The personalized regression models outperform the classical models, but having prediction models for each user, activity, and prediction time is not practical, as for our user study only, we had to maintain over 40,000 models. So, we iteratively built a generalized model by making the regression user, activity, and axis independent, which did not significantly reduce the performance. So this is our final model, which can be expressed as this simple equation. It is similar to classical models, but the main difference being the time-dependent coefficient variable alpha. And we empirically derived the values for these coefficient alphas. When compared to other approaches, our model is easy to compute and transparent. For more details on how we build the model, please refer to our paper. Next, I will discuss how we evaluated our model. For testing data, if we predict the hand location 300 milliseconds ahead, our root mean square error was 3.15 centimeters. And for predicting times less than 200 milliseconds, RMSE is lower than 1 centimeter. We also note that 340 milliseconds has the upper limit for our model, where our model's R squared score decreases below 0.9. And visually, we can see how our prediction model performed for all activities. We further tested our model for pointing tasks only. We showed us that our model had an angular error of 4 degrees from the landing position 50% of the way through the movement. Similarly, for reaching tasks, it achieved an error of 0.41 centimeters from the landing position for 50% of the way. Our model is not invincible of large errors. Large errors can especially happen for high prediction intervals as 300 milliseconds. However, less than 90% of the errors are still under 4 centimeters for a 300 milliseconds prediction interval. Now, I will move on to how we validated our model. To validate our model, we conducted a follow-up study with 3 users and 2 new tasks, which included free-form sweeping arm movements and a dancing task, where our model showed similar results to the previous study. We also tested our model with a third-party motion capture database, which included dancing movements. Here also, our model outperformed the classical models, achieving a 3.86 cm root mean square error for 300 milliseconds prediction. Our model can be used to provide timely multimodal feedback. For example, by predicting future collisions, we can render haptics beforehand. We also show that our model can be used to reconstruct missing trajectory segments due to intermittent loss of trackers. Finally, our approach is not fundamentally limited to VR. So maybe in future, using this model, we may be able to stop a rotating blade before you can touch it. To sum up, we present a kinematics-based regression model for ballistic hand movements in VR, which outperformed classical kinematics models. We showed our model is both user and activity independent, which makes it usable without additional training. Finally, we validated our model by conducting a follow-up study with new users and activities. Thank you.